Thank you and good morning everybody and welcome to Stamford Bridge. I'm delighted this morning to formally announce Jose Mourinho as the new manager of Chelsea with immediate effect.
He's the guy who's the talk of the town.
I hadn't heard too much about him. We'd seen him, you'd been impressed by his teams. He didn't look like a manager, he looked like a film star.
We'd all seen Mourinho the year before winning the Champions League. The character that he exuded, we were very excited of where this may take us.
Why Chelsea, of all the places you could have gone?
Why Chelsea?
He did walk into a group of good players, so I think Jose would admit that. We were young, hungry.
During that period, foreign managers very often tiptoed into the Premier League. They talked about their gratitude for the opportunity.
He's the top of the West, always cool. The best.
Mourinho was anything but low-key.
We have top players. And I'm sorry, I'm a bit arrogant. We have a top manager. Again, please don't call me arrogant because what I'm saying is true. I'm European champion, so I'm not one of the bottle. I think I'm a special one.
I think it was smart. I think it was a very clever press conference. In the English culture, in the Premier League, it's not probably the norm that a manager announces himself with such confidence. And it also was a message to the club and to the players that he was coming in, that he's coming in with confidence and he's coming in to be a winner.
He first spoke to us as a team. He outlined the date when we would win the league away at Bolton. He said, look, I've come here to win. And he listed players in the dressing room who had won things, and there wasn't many. He said, I'm a champion, and you know, if you follow me, you'll be champions.
We should not be afraid to say we want to win. If you ask me the biggest ambition I have, I will say to win the first Premiership match on the 14th of August. This is the biggest ambition I have. After this match, you ask me again, and I will tell you my second biggest ambition.
The title, that this season?
The second ambition is to win the second Premiership match.
I think in any sport, especially team sports, if a team's going to win at the highest level, there has to be what could be perceived as an arrogance. It's something that means we believe in ourselves, we believe the way we work, we believe in what we're going to do.
Not a bad ball, either. Drogba's header for Kubiansan! Scored 15 minutes into the new era. Mourinho has arrived, and he's arrived in style.
Mourinho didn't walk into a league he will have thought he could dominate straight away. When he looked to his left, he saw Arsene Wenger, and when he looked to his right, he saw Sir Alex Ferguson. You know, he was walking into a bear pit, really.
Jose Mourinho has begun his reign as Chelsea's coach with a win. A win against Manchester United.
It was a statement to Manchester United and Ferguson, but it was also a statement to his own players and supporters that he was capable of winning these really, really big games. Jose Mourinho was absolutely expert at getting the players to love him and respect him.
Talk about this unity that this manager's instilled. You see it there in the celebration.
And he had this hold over the players.
The most important thing, I think, is to find players who think as I think.
I think the years he spent at Barcelona as a translator, I think he was soaking up knowledge. I find that the most amazing thing about him, that he managed to learn that without feeling it as a player.
Jose earned his own luck in his formative years, working behind the scenes, becoming a manager, winning the Champions League with Porto, which is an incredible achievement when you look back. And I think the luck was the timing of coming to a club that had a core of players that were ready to go, and then he could come in and be himself.
Drogba! It's a brilliant header.
What I want is to create a football team in relation to my image.
The third consecutive victory. Jose Mourinho is still unbeaten.
In relation to my football philosophy.
We were the new boys, so the onus was on us to show that we could challenge.
I'm not a defender of old managers and new managers. I believe in good ones and bad ones, the ones who achieved success and the ones who didn't.
The boys absolutely loved him and would run through brick walls for him.
And Chelsea's Jose Mourinho can celebrate. They have won for the sixth game in a row.
In blocks of games, Jose would write them on the board in the meeting and give us like 3 points, 3 points, 3 points. It tended to happen.
Brilliantly organised, there were flashes of brilliance, and the statistics were just phenomenal.
Jose Mourinho's side continue to pinch points and be extremely miserly in defence.
It was virtually impossible to score against them. He was a fabulous defensive strategist. He saw games of football as things that you tried not to lose, first of all, before you tried to win them.
We were too good at not conceding. When you concede, very rarely, and keep a lot of clean sheets, people probably just jump to the conclusion that, oh, that's defensive or that's boring. It was the opposite of that. Ian Robin, Damien Duff, Didier Drogba, Rüdiger Johnson, lots of attacking players.
I understand the evolution of football, and I understand the needs of modern football.
He soaked up all the animosity from the players. It was all directed towards him. It fueled us, because we wanted to do it for the boss. He knew what he was saying to get under the skin of the right person at the right time.
Quickest to react.
The mentality that got installed in the beginning becomes stronger with every win and every game where you feel like you're moving forward, and that momentum just grew.
Chelsea 3, Fulham 1. Chelsea on the brink of the title now.
He first spoke to us as a team. He outlined the date when we would win the league.
Welcome to the Reebok Stadium.
Away at Bolton.
On the day that Chelsea hope to claim their first league championship title for 50 years.
It all came to a head at Bolton. And in the second half, it just exploded.
Frank Lampard with a chance! Is that the goal? Is that the goal that will seal the Premier League title for Chelsea?
Jose, you said on your first day here that you thought yourself special. Do you think you've proved that?
I don't know what you mean by special and what I mean when I told that.
And Lampard can secure the championship here, round the keeper, into the back of the net. Who can deny Chelsea now?
I know I did it, but... No, at that time I was saying I was special because I was European champions 2 days before that. So I arrive here with my ego big. You know? Now he's even higher.
Well, there's no doubt Jose improved me as a player. When he came in, I wasn't sure what my ceiling was. The biggest thing Jose Mourinho did was make me believe.
I firmly believe at this club he's the most important figure. He revolutionised English football.
Chelsea are the champions. 50 years on, Jose Mourinho has shown the world that he is indeed the special one.